An actor is an actor and who's in search of roles, trying to play different roles. A star is in search of scripts where the dress changes, but he essentially plays the same role.
Well, it's wonderful to speak to you both like this. Who would have thought, you know, that usually, you know, when you made your films, it was restricted to the journalists there. And, you know, very rarely did we get an opportunity to discuss your craft. But now it seems everybody is together. So there's some good things that have come out of this pandemic and lockdown. We are more connected.
That's good.
That's really true. Because, you know, we never thought that, I mean, when me and Hasini would be sitting on some jury and we'd be having breakfast, I would be telling her, you should be directing more often. And she says, yeah, but I've already got a great director in my household, so I don't have to worry about it. But I said, the director knew sleeping. And she told me, you should be directing more. So finally, now we both are on one project together.
And it's an awesome opportunity for me to speak to you because, as I said, I met you during Kandakondan. And the first thing he told me was, I'm so happy you've got the name right, because people in the north could not like get their, you know, tongue around the pronunciation.
Yeah.
And the same thing happened with Mani sir also. Kannathil Muttamittal. He says, now I'll give you the interview. You spelt my, you know, you have pronounced it right. So now I hope I get Puttam Pudu Kalai right. Have I or not?
Kale.
Kale.
Kalai.
Kalai. Kalai.
Yes, Kalai.
Okay. But I have seen the trailer and I've absolutely loved it. So now for both of you, what was it like to direct a movie in a lockdown? Was it a harrowing experience, a challenge that you've never come across before, or was it easy peasy?
I think, you know, of the five directors, only Rajiv and I had a dual role. He was cinematographing and directing, and I was directing and acting. For him, I think it's a little simpler because cinematography comes so naturally to him. And anyway, he's behind the camera in both. So it's okay. For me, it was tough because I have to be in front of the camera and behind the camera. So it was really difficult for me. And I'm sure it was easy for Rajiv. You can know how it was.
I kind of really enjoyed this because it was like, I didn't know where I'm, you know, going in that sense. Because when you're right, when they tell you that we'd like to make an anthology and we are contacting some people, and what's the idea that you have? Is there something that you can talk about which is happening during COVID, but which deals with people coping with the problems of COVID, I mean, the lockdown and all that, but there is a certain element of hope. So you got this bandwidth to write, and then that whatever you're writing has to be unique and it needs some kind of a focus. So you're writing, but you don't know what the others are writing. You have absolutely no idea. And then when this is going to get made, the lockdown is opening up in various stages, and then you're having weak lockdowns, and sometimes you have, you know, so we don't know where, how the lockdown is going to, you know, progress. And we don't know which actors are going to be ready to work with us.
Yeah.
And so there is that issue. But then when we reached out to the actors, you know, I think actors and filmmakers were sufficiently feeling frustrated because there didn't seem to be any end in sight. So everybody jumped in, you know, and in my case, I'm dealing with a person who is in the vulnerable age group of 65 and above, and she's of course dealing with her own mother and her father and things like being cast in one film. So, I mean, so you've got to keep the environment secure. I mean, you cannot have a situation where, you know, we take our own family members or somebody else and expose them to a disease. So you're dealing with the pandemic in your writing. You're dealing with the possibility of death and infection, which is very real, which is, I mean, it happened to S.P. Balasubramanian. I mean, you can be the richest person, you can be an MP, you can be worth 100 crores, but there's jack shit you can do if you get the corona. And you don't know why it affects some people so badly. Why it's a lottery to be alive today, you know? So in this situation, you're writing and creating, and you need to give hope, because at that point of time, television viewing was so depressing. Every day was getting worse. I mean, if you started out with hundreds of people dying, lockdown, then people are walking back, that's a problem. Then after you get over that, Galwan happens. After that, you have some cyclone, then you're having, every week was one worse than the other. And as you feel more and more besieged inside your house, you know, it's only in your mind that you're creating. And all of us were, you know, sending, you know, short stories that you're writing on your phone and things like to each other, you know. And then finally, when somebody says, okay, you can make a real film, everybody is jumping into it.
True.
But then executing it is not a difficult thing. It's a different experience. It's like taking you back to the institute days where you have 10 people and things like that. So you've got to find a new way of, you know, shooting and working around it. And, you know, simple things like getting food on a set. I mean, I was shooting around 15, 20 kilometers outside the city center and there were no restaurants. There were no restaurants to get, I mean, idli vada, which you think everywhere you get it, you drive back to Adyar to carry the food back, you know. So it was like, and there's no production people who are serving you food. So the drivers are bringing, you know, packed boxes and they have to be all kept, everybody has to be sitting separately and eating. It was great fun. So.
Ma'am, what about you? I mean, and yours is aptly titled Coffee Anyone. I know that steaming cup of filter coffee is very integral to, you know, the South and also to the North as well. And I grew up in South India. I know what that cup of coffee means. So how did that idea come about? And you've shot with your family members. Were they okay to take orders from you or were they difficult?
They were very, very easy. They were really, really easy. And anyway, they have to come back and live with me, you know. If they were not obedient in the set, they have to come back home and be with me. You know, the Yelda's had a different no fear concept of the pandemic. I don't know if Rajiv experienced it with his mother and others. My father and mother did not care about the pandemic at all. They did not bother about the lockdown because anyway they are locked down. You know, they hardly go out because of their age. My dad hardly walks outside the house, and I stop my mother from going up and down the staircase because she's above 80. So for them it was not very different, and they're not scared of death. You know,
there's
so
something about old people. There is that, yeah.
The way they looked at the pandemic itself was completely different. And for me, like Rajiv said, so many people have asked me, why haven't you directed? And I didn't have a very right answer, the proper answer for any of them. I mean, I think I was kind of creatively lazy, or I was scared to take a risk, or whatever it is. I'd been postponing it for many years. But I should tell you, in one of my short films, Rajiv acted. Was that the first time you acted, Rajiv?
Yeah, absolutely. Yes. Only time I've acted, really.
Harit, tell me.
First time I acted.
First time he acted, you know, played a role. Yeah. It was a short film called Sureka, written by our legendary writer, prolific writer, Sujata Rangarajan. And it was produced by Revati. And Chitra Krishnamurthy, you know, Shekhar Kapoor, Suchitra, she played the protagonist. And one of the heroes was Rajiv. This was many years ago. So I have made a lot of short films. So short film is something that I'm quite comfortable with writing, because I think for a lazy person like me, it's only 4 days of shooting and 1 month of my time. Not that lazy. I keep saying that I'm lazy. I think people will really believe that I'm lazy.
I know. If you keep saying it, they'll just come to believe it.
I'm not. But it's a kind of, it's a very comfortable zone for me, a short film. And they've been asking me, but the pandemic made me write. I wrote about 5 stories with money. And we also did a screenplay and we also shot some of them. When Amazon had approached all 4 of them, I had shown them my film, which I had shot on my iPhone, to Amazon people. And they said that we have a similar concept, films on pandemic. Will you direct one? The other 4 have agreed. So they came to me last, I think. They were not sure whether I will fit in or whatever. But since I had already attempted to write a lockdown story, maybe they thought they don't have to explain too many things to me, because I'd already done with a 3 crew unit. My watchman took shots, money took some shots, and you know, I kept my camera on my son's, you know, he just come back from London, his 4-wheel suitcase, and I was pushing it in the strolley and things like that. So they've seen that. So I guess they thought that I was ready, at least in terms of briefing. So I kind of accepted it and wrote two stories. And one of them was What Was Coffee Anyone? And I took the easiest approach or easiest way to shoot this. I just looked around my house and said, who are all available to act? My mother, my father, my two cousins, and I'm around. So I changed the male character into female to fit in a short story that I'd written about 10 years ago. And I completed it for Amazon, and that's how Coffee Anyone was created.
Wow. And Rajiv, so you've also shot the title track, haven't you?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
And the movies. Yeah. So, I mean, and also it's been a while since we saw you come out with a film too. So we actually should say welcome back. But also for both of you, do you realize also, you know, because Tamil content is like, I was just reading, it's 44% of the viewers consume Tamil content. And also I think the streamers are now realizing the necessity of having anthologies. And I'm seeing a lot of content from South India, which everyone is enjoying. So do you also think this has come as a boon? And also for directors, you're no longer bogged down by theatrical releases and the box office. This is a good platform.
Yeah, I think because the nature of the beast of filling 600 to 900 people in a theater means, and the large number of people who are going to the theater on the first 3 days of four shows are young guys between 18 and 25, has made the cinema hyper-masculine in that sense. You know, so the role for the middle-aged person or role for the feminine person has deteriorated as only foils to this kind of male exhibitionistic hero figure.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is seen from that perspective. Ever so often, you know, one in 50 odd films will probably buck the trend of 20, but majority of the films are there. And the tragedy is that young actors who are coming into cinema are not wanting to be actors, but wanting to be stars. So they are doing everything that the star will do. So even North India, they are building muscles. Here, they're having political ambitions even before their third film is released. You know, they want to talk about political issues. They want to talk about everything because the stars who are well known are taking a political stand. So it's not. So that is not good, because an actor is an actor and who's in search of roles, trying to play different roles. A star is in search of scripts where the dress changes, but he essentially plays the same role.
I agree with that.
So you know, it is anti-cinema and anti-writing to be dealing with a star. So you have to really work hard to take a star and then make him an actor, because he feels, I'm already successful. Why should I listen to you?
True.
My audience is already going to come. Why are you upset? So the moment an actor gets some recognition, he thinks he's a star and he starts moving. Now, what has happened in OTT is because you're dealing with an individual and not a collective audience, the gray characters are becoming more interesting. So when the breakthrough happened, whether it is Narcos or Breaking Bad, you don't know whether this person is good or bad. You don't have to say that he's villain or hero. He can be somewhere in between. He need not be young or he need not be old. He can be somewhere in between. And women who are 40, 50 year old are getting roles in OTT.
Exactly.
And subjects which are taboo about feminine desire and all these things are getting put out there. So I think it's a great space to be in. And it is augmenting the already, can I say, robust industry that we are in. We have a great, it's a fertile ground where a lot of films are being made. And now we are also having a greater democratization because of digital, that you're seeing fantastic cinema coming out of Assam or Kerala or anywhere, you know.
True.
And it's all being consumed everywhere. And I think OTT has allowed that exchange to happen.
True.
Now, this content is going to be watched in 200 countries. So God knows how many people are going to like it and watch it in Mexico or Guatemala or wherever it is. And we'll be delighted if that happens.
True. What about you, ma'am? What do you have to say? And as Sir rightly said, that, you know, we are seeing better roles being written for women of a certain age, because you've acted also. You've done path-breaking roles. But, you know, they would always say an actress's shelf life is till she gets married or she's a certain age. But now the sky is the limit. You can be as old or as young. You can do whatever you want to. Do you also see it changing?
You know, when I see Meryl Streep and Nicole Kidman coming into OTT and television, it, you know, I'm so pleased. with the bigger stars, and Reese Witherspoon being executive producer for most of the shows, and it's absolutely brilliant. The women have already taken that step to come to OTT. The men are always been slow. Sorry, they've been slow. Even in television, I think it took a long time for after Bachchan, Mr. Bachchan, for the Nagarjunas and Chiranjeevis and all of them to come to television. Whereas Revati and Suhasini and Radhika started television long ago. I'm not saying that we are better off or anything like that, but we took the risk a little earlier. I think their risk was much bigger, and they had so much to lose. So they took some time to come. And I'm a big fan of OTT. It's a kind of a dichotomy, especially when our production house is producing a film which has to be shown in a huge screen. But still, I'm not saying selfishly, theaters will have to open and things like that. OTT is a great platform. And I've been telling these guys also, for the past 6 years, I've not gone to the theaters to watch films. OTT is perfectly fine. I'm addicted to content. And I think writing in the on OTT platform is also excellent. The kind of writing that's going on, on online is like unbelievable. The short films and, I've been seeing those short films that are made by filmmakers who are inside their houses also, like 5 minutes and 3 minutes films and all. Amazing, just with the drone camera and things like that. So this is definitely not possible on the big screen. In a bigger cinema. And personally, I think I'm not happy with 2.5 hour films. I get bored with 2.5 hour films, but I'm so happy with the 10 hour content. I don't know. It's crazy.
I know.
On one side, my patience is, running out. But on the other side, I'm just waiting for the next episode to come. So I'm a big fan of OTT. And from the beginning, for filmmakers like me, if OTT had come in about 20 years earlier, I would not have stopped with Indra. I would have definitely gone on to make a couple of more films. I think the fear of Rajiv said, having 900 people and all 900 people to agree with whatever content that you're giving them, it's just so difficult. I still remember, Rajiv, when I did Indra, I had a press meet, and one press man came and told me, after listening to Nila Kaigiradu and Thoda Thoda Malarndadenna, he said, both the songs put me to sleep. Can you make a song which will wake me up? So I'm not an alarm clock here. I'm not going to ring the alarm and say, wake up, And those two songs, I saw S.P. Balasubramaniam saying recently that Thoda Thoda Malarndadenna, the song from Indira, is one of his most favorite songs. But on the other hand, there was a reporter who came and said, really boring, madam, all these slow songs. So why don't you have something fast that will wake me up?
Oh my God. No, that's how we're seeing the remixes that have just corrupted music.
Yeah, I mean, I also like popular music. I like Bruno Mars, I like foot tapping music. I'm not saying no to all that. But you can't have just that. Like Rajiv said, you can't have just heroes just changing their costume and not changing their character.
It is true.
Changing their wig, but not changing the roles.
True. And a lot of these stories wouldn't have made it to the theater, because then the producers, usually say, yeah, like here, kaun dekhega, kaun aayega, do show milega, that kind of thing. So this is liberating. But I want to know, what is a director's WhatsApp group like?
Actually, we didn't have a group at all.
We didn't.
We don't know what Raju has made, and nobody knows. I mean, ask him. He still hasn't seen my film. I haven't seen his film.
I only see snippets of it when the song was coming. Like I don't even know what. And it is so strange that when I saw those snippets, I had a gut feeling that everybody's making, films inside the houses. Everybody will have a coffee drinking sequence and all that. So I just shot all that into the music video. And now in the music video, it's intercut. It looks like it was all planned. But I was only guessing.
I haven't seen the song because it got released only 12:30 today, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, with the interviews, I'm just waiting to see the song.
Wow, awesome. But what are these virtual promotions like for the two of you who we hardly get to meet here? Are you enjoying it, finding it more connected and interesting?
You go first.
No, I think it's we just got used to. I mean, I've been teaching on Zoom and dealing with a lot of meetings on Zoom, so I've kind of got used to it, and recording and running PowerPoints on it. So like that way, it sort of got me. But I do miss an interaction. I would really have loved to meet all my buddies, and we discussed all our crazy things we would have done in the shoot over a cup of coffee. You know, I yearn for that. And I think we are going to still shoot tomorrow. I'm just looking forward to meeting
all five
of us. And then we should probably rush off to meet Mani also and have a coffee with them. So it's like we're just waiting for a reason to meet.
What about you, ma'am? Are you enjoying this whole phase, the lockdown, more time? Because, you know, we all run on autopilot. It's kind of helped us slow down, but it's also getting to everybody.
Like Rajiv, I also have been doing a lot of work on Zoom because I run an NGO for single women. So all our meetings have been on Zoom. And I also started a live broadcast on Instagram for 21 days. And each day I took on a different topic or, you know, what are the business people saying? What are the wellness, people saying about lockdown? And also had discussions with psychiatrists and singers and dancers. And, you know, dancers and singers are the most affected. I believe my son was saying opera is completely banned because that is when a lot of water droplets drop. Drama and opera is completely banned world over. It's going to take a long time. So we had discussions with all those people. So I'm kind of used to the Zoom format and online format. And it's fine. But the promotion, as Rajiv mentioned, it would have been nice to meet all of you in person.
True.
Nothing like flesh and blood, you know. And for this interview too, I just sprayed a little bit of perfume and then realized, oh my God, they can't even
the smell. Fragrance comes across. I know what you mean. But it's been awesome speaking to you. So now, will we see more coming from the two of you, or do we have to wait a little longer?
No, we definitely, at this rate, we'll probably make a film. All five of us will not make an anthology.
Yeah, I think, yeah. I already have one story that one of
Let's do it. Come on, let's start it.
Direct something connected to this. So it's ready. So, you know, we are ready to collaborate again.
I'm so looking forward to that. It's been wonderful speaking to you. I hope to meet you in person soon. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.